this session, we are discussing stack in data structure. So, what is a stack in data structure and when we should go for stack concept? So, in this session, we will discuss stack in data structure. So, when we should go for stack and what is a stack and how stack will work in data structure? Now, before understanding the stack, first of all, we are try to understand how you can arrange the data in array. Suppose if you have any array, suppose I have this an array. In this array having the capability to storing 5 elements. Suppose this array having the capability to holding 5 elements. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Every element are store one index position. So every element contain one index position. It means the position which are indicating in which location the element is stored. So last element position is 4. So in the array, if you want to store element, suppose if you are inserting a new element 10. So 10 we are storing in which location? At 0 location. Now if you want to insert a new element again, so the new element comes into the first position. Now if you want to insert new element at the fourth position, you can insert directly also fourth position. It means if you want to perform insertion operation means if you want to insert any element inside an array, you can store element inside an array at randomly at any position directly. It means you can add any element inside the array at randomly in what location you want to add. Just tell the location of the array. Suppose array name is A and we want to store in which location? Third position. In that third position we want to store 30 value. So 30 value goes into which location? In this location. So it means if you want to add, you can add element inside the array at any location randomly. If you want to extract the element, suppose I want to know what is the second element. How you can know? You can extract element at any position randomly also. It means you can perform insertion and you can perform extraction randomly inside an array. Array is allowed to store the data randomly. You can store any position randomly. And you can also extract the data from the array randomly. So whatever data you want to extract, just tell the name of the array along with its index position, you can extract the data. So this is the way to storing the data inside the array. But suppose my requirement such type, I want to store the data, suppose this is an container where we are storing the data. Inside this container, suppose I am storing first data 10, so the 10 data is stored here. So now if you want to store new data, so what new data? Suppose new data is 20. So now whenever you want to store new data, the new data always add to the top of its previous data. So what my requirement? Try to understand. My requirement is whenever we want to add new data, the new data always adds at the top of the previous data. So what is the previous data? 10. So if you want to insert new data, the new data inserted at the top of the previous data, it means that 20 added here. Now if you want to add another data, suppose we want to add 30, so 30 data always adds to the previous at the top of the previous data. So what in this time previously data? 20. The previous data was added, the new data always added at the top of the previous data. So now 30 data here added. So in this manner, if you want to add the data, in this manner, if you want to store the data. So whenever user try to add new data, whenever user try to insert a new data, it means always new data item always added the top of the previous data. So we can't store randomly data. In this scenario, we are not able to storing the data randomly in any orders. But the data always added the top of the previous data. So if you want to extract the data, suppose if you want to extract the, you can extract the only that data that the data was added recently. Which data recently added? 30. So you can pop this data, you can delete, you can extract this data 30. It means whatever operation you want to perform, that operation you can perform only top of the element. It means the data which are started at the first time, that data always goes out at the last of the data. Clear? It means whatever we are storing the data first, that data comes out at the last, and whatever data we are added in recently, that data always comes out first. So in this principle, if we want to work, then we should go for which concept? Then we should go for stack concept. Stack is also linear data structure. But stack, how to allow to store the data? The stack is always allowed to store the data at the top of the element. So the question is that when we should go for a stack. What problem with an array? If you are take the array and try to start the data inside the array, you can store the data in randomly order, in any order, at any location randomly. And you can extract the data also from any locations. But I want to provide some restriction. You can add, you can delete, you can extract the data only from the top of the element. So then we should go for a stack concept. So I hope you will understand when we should go for a stack concept. In the next session, next video session, we will discuss why we are using the stack and what is a stack. Thank you.